If we look at trigonometry, grade 10 revision of ratios, we learned last year the Cartesian plane is drawn and I want to calculate this inclination angle. I have x and y. Down is my x value, left is my y, because this is my y axis and this is my x axis. Then we can calculate the ratios of sine, cosine and tangent. Y sine is y over r, cosine is x over r, and tangent is y over x. But you could have also learned that sine is opposite side, so it's my opposite side over the hypotenuse. Okay, and this side, it is the adjacent side over the skew side, if I can say it like that. Okay, and then this will be my opposite, tangent is the opposite over the adjacent side. It's easy as that, opposite over adjacent. Okay, now we're going to look at an example. If I look at this example, I give you a Cartesian plane with the inclination angle at alpha, and this point is 3, my y, and my x is 2. Before I even look at what I need to calculate r. So therefore r squared equals x squared plus y squared, and I know this is Pythagoras. Please indicate that always. Now we know that x is negative 2, square it. We know that y is 3 and we square it. So we know negative 2 squared is 4 and 3 squared is 9. 4 plus 9 is 13 and my radius is always positive. Okay, so this value is always positive. Now to make it easier, I always write my x on its value is negative 2, my y is 3 and my r is the square root of 13. Just to make the calculations easier when I do it. Okay, so that's my iPad note, side note. Okay, so if I look at number one, tan alpha. We know that tan is y over x. It's y over x. So it's 3 over negative 2. Zoom, zoom, first one done. Then we go to number 2, sine square alpha plus cosine square alpha. We know that sine, we're going to square it, and we're going to square cos. Okay, if I look, sine is y over r. You need to know that out of your head. It's y over r, so it's 3 over the square root of 30. And cos is x over r, so it's negative 2 over the root of 13. You will lose a mark if you substitute in wrong. Now 3 squared is 9, root of 13 squared is 13. Negative 2 squared is 4, the root of 13 is squaring the square root of 13 is 13. Now the 13s is the same, so I just say 9 plus 4, it's 13 over 13, and therefore that gives me 1. Let's see if I work correctly. Press that in my calculator. 3 over the square root of 13 squared. You can use your calculator from the beginning. No worries. I'm going to get 9 over 13. Press that in my calculator. Negative 2 over the square root of 13 squared. Square it. I get 4 over 13. Then I say 4 over 13 plus 9 over 13, I get 1. Did I do my calculation correctly? Yes. Now we look at number 3. Number 3 is 30 sine alpha multiplied by cos alpha. So therefore, 13 times sine, we said sine is 3 over 13. Multiply by cos, we said cos is negative 2 over 13. Square root of 13 times square root of 13 is 13. 13 over 13 is 1. So all I'm going to say is 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. What did he do? Press in your calculator. 13 bracket 3 over the square root of 13, bracket, negative 2 over the square root of 13. Does it give me negative 6? Zim zam, it gives me negative 6. Well done, that was easy. Now, for example 2. In this example, there's no sketch, so you need to go draw the sketch. So I take what they gave me, the equation, that's 17 cos theta equals negative 8, and I get cos 11. And therefore, it's negative 8 over 17. Then I draw a small Cartesian plane, any one of them. So get cos or sine alone, see if it's positive. Here, cos is negative. All students talk crap. It's not positive, it's negative. So now I'm asking myself, and I'm going to make a tick, where is cos negative? Cos is positive in those two, so it's negative there, quadrant 2 and quadrant 3. So that's what I did, firstly. Secondly, I look at my angle. My angle is an element of 180 to 360. 180 to 360, so it's quadrant 2, quadrant 4. Quadrant 3 and quadrant 4. I have two ticks in which quadrant? Quadrant 3. So we're going to sketch and work in quadrant 3. So the angle we calculate is there, and therefore cos sine is what? Sine is y. Okay, I always write sine is y over r. Cosine is x over r. Tangent is what? Y over x. Okay, so what do we have? We have the x value. So if I go down, I have my x, that's negative 8. Yes, that's the negative sign. Radius is always positive, and does not reach 17. So I need to calculate y. So r squared equals x squared plus y squared. We're using Pythagoras. What is r? R is 17, we square it. What is x? X is negative 8, we square it. Y squared. 17 squared is 289. Negative 8 squared is positive 64. Take 64 to the other side, becomes negative 64. 289 minus 64 is equals to 225. Y squared. Now we square root both sides, so we're going to have plus minus 15. So y is plus or minus the plus or minus 15. But in this scenario, my y value here at the bottom is negative 15. So y is negative 15. So now we have a side note. We have x is equals to negative 8. Y is equals to negative 15. And r is equals to 17. That's my iPad cheat note. Now I can calculate anything. Now we look, what do you want me to calculate? I must calculate 8 tan theta minus 17 sine theta. So 8 times tangent minus 17 of sine. What is tan? Tan, we said, is y over x. Y over x. Negative 15 over negative 8. What is sine? Sine is y over r. Y over r. Negative 15 over 17. You can use a calculator if you want. Negative, negative, makes positive. 8 cancels out. So I have 15 here. Negative times negative is positive. 17 cancels out. Left with 15. 15 plus 15 is 30. Let's double check. So I say 8 bracket. Negative 15 over negative 8. Close the bracket. Positive 15. Negative 17 bracket. Negative 15 over 17. Close the bracket. 15. 15 plus 15 is 30. Zoom zoom. Example 2 done. So here's your revision question. Pause the video and I'm going to answer these questions about last year's work. Okay. Enjoy. Only those five.